Yeah, good morning, students. So today we are going to discuss about the second part in the story of microorganisms. So in our textbook, there are two chapters are there in the story of microorganisms. Story of microorganisms part 1 completed. In that part 1, part 2, part 3, in that I taught. Now the second part we are going to discuss. The story of microorganisms part 2. So in that part 1 we are going to discuss. Story of microorganisms. Story of microorganisms. Part 2 here. Story of microorganisms, this is the part 2. In the previous we discussed about the part 1. Okay. So what we are going to learn here? We are going to learn about the microorganisms useful and harmful. In the previous class we know there are different types of microorganisms. We know bacteria, we know algae, fungi, arthropods and protozoans. So these are all we learned in the part 1. Now we are going to discuss among them which are useful and which are harmful. So some of the microorganisms are useful for us. Some of the microorganisms are causes for diseases. So which are useful, those are called the friends of the friendly microorganisms, we call them. So some of the bacteria or some of the microorganisms make the soil fertile. So those are friends of the farmers also, we can call them. So useful microorganisms we call them. So here, to know all the useful and harmful microorganisms, there are different activities in our textbook. In them, the first activity we are going to discuss the useful bacteria. Whether is it useful or harmful, by doing that activity we can find out that. Activity 1 we are going to discuss. Activity 1. What is given here in that activity 1? We have to take 2 bowls. How many? 2 bowls. So I am going to draw another picture. Here these are the 2 bowls. Okay. 2 bowls. I give the names to them, 1 and 2. Bowl 1 and bowl 2. This is 1 and the second one, that is. So how many bowls did I take? I took 2 bowls. In that we have to take lukewarm milk. Lukewarm milk. Lukewarm milk. What is the meaning of lukewarm? Little hot milk. Little temperature is same in that milk. So that milk we have to take in the 2 bowls. How many bowls are there? 2 bowls are there. In that we have to give. Two bowls filled with the lukewarm milk. So in the 2 bowls we pour the lukewarm milk certain quantity, 100 ml or 200 ml or 250 ml, whatever it is. Later on we add 1 or 2 drops of curd or buttermilk. What we have to add? Curd or buttermilk. So we are going to add curd or buttermilk. Not in 2 bowls. We added curd or buttermilk in the first bowl itself. In the second we didn't add any curd or buttermilk. Let it be up to 5 to 6 hours. Leave that 5 to 6 hours. Up to 6 hours, keep them somewhere, we no need to touch them and let it be like that. After that, you have to go and see
What do you observe? That we want to know. For that, in our textbook, there are three questions are there. The first question, observe the ball. You have to go and observe. If you observe, what changes did you find? You see that, is there any change? Definitely there is some changes. There is a change you will find. Then the third question, what is the reason for that change? So here, first you have to observe. We observe. Yes, here some change we found. In bowl one is look like the curd and bowl two like milk itself. Then what change did we observe? Here bowl one change as a curd and bowl two as this like milk. And what is the reason behind this? There is a reason behind that. If we add curd or buttermilk to the milk, in that buttermilk or curd, there is a bacterium. There is a bacterium, lactobacillus. Lactobacillus bacterium. Bacteria name lactobacillus bacterium. That lactobacillus bacterium changed milk into curd. This bacteria milk convert into curd. This is a microorganism helps milk convert into curd. Now, can we call it useful useful microorganism or not? We can call it as a useful microorganism because we cannot see the bacteria with our aided eye. We need an instrument which is microscope. By using the microscope, we can observe the bacteria. Without the microscope, we can't see. This bacteria can change milk into curd. That's what it is called as useful bacteria, useful microorganism. So this is the activity one. So what did we do here? First we took two bowls. In that look warm milk in the two bowls equal amount. In the first bowl we added two drops of curd or buttermilk. In the second bowl we didn't add curd or buttermilk. We kept both bowls along with that milk at a particular place without disturbing 5 to 6 hours. What happened there? The first bowl changes. In the first bowl, milk changes as a curd. The second bowl has this like milk itself. What is the reason? The reason behind that, there is a bacterium in the curd or in the buttermilk that develops more number by the reproduction and milk changes as a curd. That is a useful bacteria. That is useful bacteria. So why do we call useful microorganism? We cannot see that. So that's what it is useful microorganism. So by doing this activity, we can conclude that there are some of the useful microorganisms. So in this activity, the useful microorganism is lactobacillus bacteria. This is the conclusion of activity 1. Tomorrow we discuss with activity 2. Later on we go with the other activities. So in this second chapter, the story of microorganisms part 2, that part 1 is activity 1. In that activity 1 we learnt about useful bacteria. This is the conclusion of this session.